Hey there, how is it going? So I took inspiration from one of my previous videos where I created a quiz app, and this is essentially where this list comes from, but I wanted to use this list for a different purpose here. Because for example, if you come from JavaScript, when you use .map to iterate on a list, you're used to it being very easy to reach an index. And sometimes it's really important, you know, you need the index of the current element to do something. And that's pretty much what I'm going to show you how to do. In this example, I'm going to show you two different alternatives that you can make whatever element of the map just tell you its index. And right now, if you just tap it, it will automatically print the value right here. As you can see, it all makes sense. You know, this is indexed 2, so it's going to print 2. And this is all that I'm going to do in this video. I'm just going to show you how to print the value of the index. But you will already have the value and you can use it to do whatever you need. So if you do want to learn how to access the index of a map using Dart, then all you have to do is stick around until the end of the video. So here we are. If you want to see the original list, it was this list of questions. And you know, I just pretty much took it as an example. It doesn't really matter what kind of list it is. In fact, this is the only list that's relevant. The only thing you need to know is that there is this variable called our list, and it's targeting, you know, this list questions and index 0, because, you know, this is index 0. This is a list, right? And this is index 0 of said list. And once we're in index 0, we want to specify the key of the information we want to retrieve. In this case, it's answers. I could even delete this, but it doesn't really matter, so I'm just going to leave it in. What matters is we're accessing the answers right here. So this right here, our list, equates to this list right here. And the reason it says this right here is because if you just leave it like this, there won't be any apparent errors right here. But if you scroll down a little bit, you can't map this list anymore. And that's because Dart just gets a little bit confused about what this is, because it's such a weird list. And that's why I use this as an example, so that you can understand that even if you have a weird list, this will still work. But anyway, that's pretty much it. And you're just saying, telling Dart, you know, this is a list of type map, and the map is of type string and object. That's all that's going on over here. So let's just get straight into it now. So I'm going to show you two different methods to get the index of your map. And the first one is super simple. It's going to be really quick. So you just come over here and you use the name of the list, you know, our list right here. Don't forget that that's the name. And then you just do .indexOf. And then you do the element. So this element right here is this element. And you know, if you're in this video, you probably already know how maps work. This variable represents each of the elements that are being iterated by the map. So when you tap each of these elements, it will tell you the index of the element that you tapped. I'm gonna hit save. But I don't know why I hit save, because the goal is to print this. My bad. I'm just gonna do this real quick. And boom, now it is printing it. I'm gonna hit save and I'm just gonna tap index, you know, this is 4, so it's index 3. I'm going to tap 3 and boom, it's a 3. And you know, it's pretty much what it is. You know, you tap and the index shows up. That's pretty much it. So now that this has been taken care of, if you come from something like JavaScript, maybe you actually just, I don't know, you really want this to be able to just have an index like this. Because for those who don't know, in JavaScript, if you map something, you can just do this and you access the index of each element just like that. So how can we make this work? I'm even going to leave this like this, because we're going to come back later and this will work when we come back. So what we're going to do is we're going to create our very own version of a map in Dart, except our version will have an index variable. And the way that you do that, well, at least one of the ways that you do that, is you can use the extension. And let's call this extension indexedIterable, and it's type E, and we're going to do it on iterable type E, of course. And then we just need to open it up with some curly braces and not screw this up. Let me just capitalize this I over here. Okay, there you go. And now here we're going to create a function. We're going to do iterable of type T this time. And now you're going to be defining the name of the function that you're going to use instead of the map function. I'm going to call this indexed map, but you can call it map index or whatever you want. It's really up to you. And it's also going to be of type T. Now, as I said, this is a function. So like you would with any other function, you open parentheses. And here we're going to create our own function as well, like this. And of course, parentheses again. And here we're going to define the arguments that we're talking about. We need, you know, E for element. I'm gonna call this element instead of E. And then, you know, an int called, well, I'm gonna call it index. You can call it whatever you want. And then just don't forget to put in this F, it's very important. And now, of course, we need the body of the function. So another pair of curly braces, and we're gonna create a new variable. I'm gonna call it index, and it's gonna equal 0. And finally, the only thing that's left is to return. Now, what are we returning? The map function, exactly. So we use the map function like so. Let me just close it up already. And here we return the little thing we just created, or rather the little function. Just do F, then we summon this E right here. And of course, we hit it with the index, except we increment it with each iterable. This is the secret right here. And that's it. Like, we have already finished it. We now have our very own version of a map, except with an index. So we just grab this right here, the name of the map that we just created, our very own custom map. And I'm going to replace this, and everything will magically work. Just like that. And now instead of all of this, all we need to do is type in index, because it's literally what we put in here. And now I'm just gonna hit save real quick, and it will work all the same. I'm just gonna click this, and as you can see, the correct index is showing up. You know, 0, this is 2, this is 5, no, 4, oops, my bad. But you know, it works, that's what matters. So if you needed to find out how to use, you know, the index of a map, now you know 2 different ways to do it. So just pick whatever you want, do whatever you want, and good luck with your project. If you're not feeling too lazy and this video helped you, please hit that like button. And if you want to keep on learning more about Dart and Flutter, then please go ahead and subscribe. I appreciate any kind of support for the channel. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.